Sanctissima, number 208.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Your Excellency, Bishop Tobin, good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to the 100th anniversary of the celebration of the institution of the Legion of Mary. It's through your continued support of the Legion of Mary that we have been able to thrive in this diocese so far and continue to thrive in our efforts to serve our Lord under the guidance of Our Lady and through your leadership as our head shepherd in the Diocese of Providence, we continue to do so. And so we thank you for taking the time to celebrate this Mass in honor of the 100th anniversary of its institution, and with that continued support and help, we hope to continue to spread the message of our Lord throughout the Diocese of Providence and, please God, the world. So thank you.
Father Denino, thank you very much for your kind welcome. I'm very happy and honored to be with you and the members of the Legion of Mary today for the celebration of your 100th anniversary. We do so, of course, on a beautiful feast day, Solemnity of Christ our King. So let's pray well together. Brothers and sisters, let's acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
In excelsis Deo,
et in terra pax hominibus, bone voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te,
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whose will is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of the universe, grant, we pray, that the whole creation, set free from slavery, may render your majesty service and ceaselessly proclaim your praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the ancient one and was presented before him, the one like a son of man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord is King.
Lectura del libro del Apocalipsis del apóstol San Juan. Hermanos míos, gracia y paz a ustedes de parte de Jesucristo, el testigo fiel, el primogénito de los muertos, el soberano de los reyes de la tierra, aquel que nos amó y nos purificó de nuestros pecados. Con su sangre y ha hecho de nosotros un reino de sacerdotes para su Dios y Padre. El ángel, la gloria y el poder por los siglos de los siglos. Amén. Miren, Él viene entre las nubes y todos lo verán, aun aquellos que lo traspasaron. Todos los pueblos de la tierra harán duelo por su causa. Yo soy el alfa y el omega, dice el Señor Dios, el que es, el que era y el que ha de venir. Palabra de Dios.
Amén.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the kingdom of our father David that is to come. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Pilate said to Jesus, "Are you the King of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you say this on your own, or have others told you about me?" Pilate answered, "I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom does not belong to this world. If my kingdom did belong to this world, my attendants would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not here." So Pilate said to him, "Then you are a king." Jesus answered, "You say I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, my dear brothers and sisters, I'm very pleased to welcome all of you to the cathedral today as we gather to celebrate a beautiful, beautiful feast day, the Solemnity of Christ the King, and a very special welcome to all the members of the Legion of Mary here in the Diocese of Providence who have come together to observe and celebrate their 100th anniversary. What a very special occasion and blessed event this is. Dear members of the Legion of Mary, we are so grateful for and proud of your ministry here in the Diocese of Providence. We're so grateful for your works of prayer and charity and evangelization. By your commitment, by your service and your apostolic work, you are helping the kingdom of God become a reality in our midst. You know, this year the Diocese of Providence is celebrating its 150th anniversary, right in the middle of our sesquicentennial. But through a good part of the history of the diocese, the Legion of Mary has been here doing your wonderful work. So thank you for all that you have done and continue to do, and congratulations on this important celebration. And please keep up your good work. It's important. We need you now as much as ever before. So God bless you and keep up the great work you have been doing. We gather today on the Solemnity of Christ the King as we bring to an end one liturgical year of the church. Then next week we will start another year with the first Sunday of Advent. Hard to believe the time is passing that quickly, isn't it? Already Advent begins next week and we prepare ourselves for the coming of the Lord at Christmas time. But today is the Feast of Christ the King as we celebrate the culmination of history, the culmination of another liturgical year. Today's gospel contains a very significant question. For Pontius Pilate asked Jesus, "Are you a king?" Now Jesus doesn't answer that directly, but later on he says, "My kingdom does not belong to this world." In other words, the kingdom of Christ is not a political kingdom that's taken by force or by military might. The kingdom of Christ is characterized by spiritual values. As we say in the preface of the Mass today, the kingdom of God is an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. The virtues, the values of God's kingdom. Now, I suppose it can be a little bit frustrating sometimes, a little bit discouraging, because as we look at the world around us, it seems that the virtues of God's kingdom are absent. The virtues of God's kingdom are so far removed from the world in which we live and move and work every day. But it's important we don't get discouraged. Don't give up. We need to be patient, always, to be patient, trusting in God's plan, trusting in God's providence. Someday, we know, Jesus will come to finish his work. Someday, we know, Jesus will come to bring his kingdom to completion. So until then, we know that we will live in a time of struggle. We will live in a time of imperfection and incompleteness. It's true, the kingdom of God is here. It is in our midst, as Jesus himself said. But the kingdom of God is not yet complete. And we live in that in-between time. In-between time, kingdom of God already begun, but the kingdom of God not yet complete. So, dear brothers and sisters, what do we do in the meantime? Well, first of all, we pray for the coming of God's kingdom. We pray fervently as we do every time we say the Lord's Prayer. Every time we say the Our Father, we say, Thy kingdom come. And we work for the kingdom. We not only pray for it, we work for the kingdom and proclaim the kingdom by our works of charity and justice and peace. You see, the kingdom of God already begun is not yet complete. The kingdom of God is an ongoing building project. But every time we help someone, forgive someone, welcome someone, or say a few kind words, every time we do one of those good works, we help to build the kingdom of God one brick at a time. But remember, dear brothers and sisters, while we do our part, Jesus is King, and God is still in charge. God bless you. Together now, let us stand and profess the faith we share. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Now, with confidence in God's presence and his goodness and his care for us every day, we come before him to offer these prayers.
Paul, the Holy Father, Pope Francis, all bishops, and all the priests, as they continue to shepherd God's people, they lead them to faithful subject to Christ our King with the assistance of Our Lady. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leader of nation, all nation, through the prayers and intercession of Our Lady, that they realize a deep recognition that Christ is the King of universe, and that they lead the people serve to more deeply realizing all the subject in this role. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church throughout the world, that the good news of the Good Shepherd will reach all people, especially through the effort of the Legion of Mary and the assistance of Our Lady, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the continued growing in holiness of all God's people, most especially those who serve Him under the stand of Our Lady as a member of the Legion of Mary, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Legion of Mary spread the message of the gospel, those who hear in our down closer to our Lord, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the canonization of Frank Duff, whose vision has inspired us under the guidance of Our Lady to undertake and carry out great things for the glory of God and the salvation of souls, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have gone before us in faith, especially the deceased member of the Legion of Mary throughout the world, that they be brought into the eternal bliss to the presence of our Lord and Our Lady, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. Almighty God, through our works of charity and justice and peace, help us to proclaim the reality of your kingdom in our midst. Hear these prayers offered in faith and confidence and answer them through Christ, our Lord and King. Amen. Amen.
The offertory hymn is number 335, Crown Him with Many Crowns, number 335.
Crown Him with Many Crowns.
Glories now we sing, who died and rose.
crown him the Lord of peace, whose power a scepter sways. From pole to pole, that wars may cease, absorbed in prayer and praise. His reign shall know no end, and round his pierced feet fill flowers of paradise, extend their fragrance ever.
I pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we offer you, O Lord, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you, we humbly pray that your Son himself may bestow on all nations the gifts of unity and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For you anointed your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness as eternal priest and king of all creation, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption, and making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to the immensity of your majesty an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Dominus Deus
are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saints Peter and Paul, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops and all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for yourself.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Humilis, pauper,
Thank you.
Let us pray. Having received the food of immortality, we ask, O Lord, that glorifying in obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the universe, we may live with him eternally in his heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Your Excellency, Bishop Tobin, Reverend Fathers, Reverend Deacons, brothers, religious sisters, and seminarians, and brothers and sisters in Christ, members of the Legion of Mary, friends, families, parishioners of this wonderful cathedral. This, as Bishop has said, is an extraordinary moment. And we are so grateful to Bishop Tobin for all the support over the years that he has given us. Particularly, we note the very frequent comments by Bishop with regard to evangelization. And I am reminded that, as we all are, 100 years ago, in the city of Dublin, Ireland, which was devastated at that time with poverty and suffering of all kinds, that ordinary people, the faithful, people like us, they together with Frank Duff, they went down on their knees and they prayed the rosary. And they prayed that the Holy Spirit would inspire them to go into action for God's church. And it so happened that in that very room, we had a statue of Our Lady of Grace of the Immaculate Conception, similar to what we have here. So 100 years ago was the call for the faithful, in particular, to follow our Lord's words, and that is that to the best of our ability that we would accept the commission to go forth. And all that's asked of us 100 years ago and today, together with our Pope, our cardinals, our bishops, our priests, our religious, is that we go forth to share our faith. We are not allowed to keep it to ourselves. We must share it, and we share our faith as they did 100 years ago, not realizing that they were starting a society of what's now 14 million throughout the world in every corner. So we recognize our beginnings, we recognize our Lord, and we recognize our Blessed Mother, and we know that we can do nothing by ourselves, that we must open our heart. And we are grateful, those of us who are in the Legion of Mary and all the friends of the Legion of Mary family worldwide, we recognize that the queen of our organization is the Blessed Mother, and that she recognizes that if we are alive today, as we are in this cathedral today, in these difficult times, that the hope is that we recognize that our Lord can use us if we open our hearts and allow him to do so. So that's all we have to do. We share our faith, and we thank Bishop Tobin most sincerely for all that he has done for us in the Legion and for all his parishioners and for all Catholics in this diocese. I thank you, Bishop. are invited to come downstairs. We are moving now with the next stage of this beautiful day into exposition and adoration and rosary, and then downstairs for a beautiful reception. And everybody present, and indeed others that could not be with us, will be coming later, all invited downstairs. Thank you again.
Ed, thank you very much for your very kind and gracious words. And indeed, as Ed mentioned, we will be concluding Holy Mass now with the exposition of our Lord Jesus on the holy altar. Jesus, our Lord, our Shepherd, Christ, our King, will be present here among us in a very special way. So as we expose the Blessed Sacrament, we hope that you can spend a little bit of time with the Lord Jesus and bring to him all your needs, the needs of your family and friends, the needs of the church and the world. Indeed, we know Christ will be present among us, and he will always hear and listen to and answer our prayers. And with that spirit of humility and trust, we conclude our Mass now with the exposition of the Blessed Sacrament.
commandment,